Set up a switch outside could be a challenge. There are several things we need to deal with. That would be including the harsh environment, the location to put up the switch, the power source, how to connect the switch back to the main switch. In this video, I'm going to talk about how to set up the switch outside, so eventually we can hook up the network device such like IP camera, access point, VoIP phone to the switch. I also use the fiber optic cable. I choose the fiber optic cable because the fiber optic cable can provide fast speed, low latency, and long distance run. And more importantly, we don't need to worry about the surge while we use the fiber optic cable. With the K5E or K6 Ethernet cable, the surge could be observed by the cable and travel to both ends. But the fiber optic cable basically is just the glasses. There's no need to worry about the surge. Okay, now let's move to the demonstration wall and set up the basic system for outside. The first challenge is the harsh environment. There's always rain, even snow outside. So we need to keep the switch in a waterproof enclosure. Or we can just use the outdoor PoE switch like this one. This is the rubber sealed. It can stop the water. After we put on the front cover will press the rubber seal and stop the water enter into this enclosure. The second place we need to pay attention is the place the cable goes through. The water may still sneak into the enclosure through the cable, so we need to have some accessory to stop the water. You may see there's some kind of waterproof outdoor switch with the hole open both sides. The reason they put on the hose is because they are too hot inside, so it needs to have the air vent to let out the hot air. But actually, it also creates an opportunity for the moisture to enter into the enclosure. Even the rain cannot go into, but the humidity still can enter into the enclosure, and eventually, it could crush the connection. So it's always better to use the IP67 waterproof enclosure. So there's no way the water or moisture can enter into the enclosure. The power source is being built into this PoE switch, so there's no need to have the external power source. We are using the AC power. This is the power connecting to AC outlet. It's important you have ground the switch. It can reduce the surge from the air or from the AC power. Then the second thing is about where to put on the switch. You see, the one rule is always keep the switch out of sunlight. Because if there's sunlight just project to the front, basically will increase the temperature, working temperature inside of the switch dramatically. Especially summer, then basically you're cooking the switch. So it's always better to keep the switch out of sunlight. Also, you should place the switch where it could be easier to access, just for future maintain purpose. Okay, the last thing is how to connect this switch to a device like this IP camera. It's quite easy. This is the PoE switch. It not only provides the data, but also the power. So we can just connect the cable to the IP device, IP camera, or wireless access point directory. The switch will provide the power and the data is changed to the device. There's no need for power source for each of the device. I'm using a short patch code to do the demonstration. Actually, the maximum distance between the switch to this camera up to 328 feet. So the camera or the access point could be located different location from this switch. All right, now next thing is let's link this switch back to the main network. I'm using the fiber optic cable, like what I mentioned. The reason is not only it can provide low latency and fast speed, we also could have surge free. The cable will not observe the surge. And I'm using the pre-made fiber optic cable, so that I don't need to handle the connector. The connector is being made in the factory. It's simply just plug and play with the pulling out. All right, in order to work with the fiber optic cable, we also need to have this device. This is the SFP transceiver. The SFP transceiver will convert the electronic data signal to the optical signal. Okay, Let me install the SIP transceiver. Then we can attach the fiber optic cable to the SIP transceiver. I just need one of the fiber optic cable. This is the BIDI SIP transceiver. It uses different wavelength to transmit and receive the data. So we don't need to have two, we just need one fiber optic cable, that would be enough. Okay. I'm going to just pick one of the cable, I'm using 8. Then we connect to the SIP transceiver. The SIP transceiver determines what kind of fiber optic cable we can use. And we are using the single mode fiber optic cable, and also what kind of connector you can use. Here is the LC connector. Okay, now let's move to the main and make the connection for the center. This is the PoE switch. We do have two SIP slots, which means we can link two switches to this main switch. If your switch doesn't have the SIP slot, then you can use this media converter. Basically, the media converter will convert the fiber optic signal to the electronic signal. So this is the RJ45 network port we are familiar with. And this is the SIP slot. Alright, now let's just use the SIP slot on the switch. We also need to install the SIP transceiver. Then we use one cable, just the same tape with the 8, and connect to the SIP transceiver. The network video recorder has been connecting to the switch. So just in a moment, we are seeing the cameras live now. Yes, the cameras live on the monitor. I would like to emphasize one thing. In this setup, the power source is available next to the outdoor PoE switch. If the power source is not available, I will recommend that you check my another video, how to send the power together with the fiber optic cable.